The Second Voyage, adapted from a story from The Arabian Nights by Marjorie Greene.
I had made up my mind to stay quietly in Baghdad, but it was not long before I grew bored of a quiet life. I wanted to see the rest of the world, so I decided to set sail once again. I bought a stock of goods with which to trade, and I set sail with some of my merchant friends. For many days we went from one island to another, trading and making a tidy profit. One day, though, we came to an island that seemed to be covered with fruit trees. There was neither man nor animal anywhere to be seen. We decided to go ashore. My friends went to gather fruit and flowers, but I took some food and sat in the shade of a huge tree. After eating a good meal, I lay down to sleep. I don't know how long I slept, but when I awoke and looked out to sea, the ship had gone. It was nearly out of sight, a distant speck on the horizon. I called out to my companions, but they had gone. Not knowing what to do, I climbed up to the top of a tall tree and looked out over the island. In the distance, I could see something white, and I decided to find out what it was. I packed up my remaining food and set off across the island. After a while, I came to what seemed like a huge white dome or ball. It was smooth to the touch. It was so high that I could not see the top of it, and it was more than 50 paces around. Suddenly, the sky above me became dark, as if a huge cloud was covering it. Looking up, I saw the shadow of a huge bird flying towards me. I had often heard sailors talk of a mysterious and wonderful bird called a roc. This must be one, I thought, and this huge dome must be its egg. The bird came nearer and finally sat on its egg. I crept close to the egg. Near me, I saw one of the bird's legs, which was as big as a tree. I decided to tie myself to the leg with my turban, so that when it flew away from the island, it would carry me with it. At first light, the bird took off and up so high that the island was soon out of sight. Then she came down again so fast that I lost my senses. When I found myself on the ground, I quickly untied the turban, just as the bird caught up a snake with her beak and flew away. I found myself surrounded on all sides by great mountains that reached high above the clouds. The sides of the valley looked so steep that there was no possibility of climbing them. At first, I thought I had gained nothing by my flight, but when I began to explore the valley, I found that there were huge diamonds just lying on the ground. I could not believe the riches lying about me, but then I saw something that frightened me. All along the slopes of the valley, there were huge serpents, some of them big enough to swallow an elephant. They came out of their dens at night, and during the day, they hid themselves from the rock. I found a long, narrow cave to hide in, and rolled a large stone in front of the entrance to keep out the serpents, but the noise of their hissing outside made sleep impossible. I was glad when they went to their dens at dawn. I was able to come out again, but I was still afraid. In fact, I found myself walking upon diamonds without a thought of their value. At last, being very tired, I decided to eat a little of my food and then to have a short sleep in the sun. I was suddenly awakened by something falling near me. I sat up and found that it was a huge piece of raw meat. I looked up and could see more pieces falling down from the rocks above the valley. I had heard stories in the past about this valley of diamonds, but had never believed them. Now, though I saw with my own eyes how the local merchants collected the jewels, they used huge eagles to carry the diamonds for them. When the eagles had young ones in their nests, they flew down into the valley to get food for them. So the merchants would throw down large pieces of raw meat, and the diamonds would stick to the meat. And when the eagles took the meat back to their nest, they also took the diamonds. Each merchant had his own nest and considered any jewels in it his. The idea came to me that I too could use these eagles to escape from the valley. The eagles were so big and strong that my weight would be nothing to them. First, I collected some of the biggest diamonds I could find, which I put in my wallet and tied at my waist. Then, I tied one of the large pieces of meat to my back with my turban. I then lay down with my face to the ground and waited. There was the sound of huge wings about me. Then I felt myself lifted up and carried to the top of the rocky walls of the valley. As the eagle reached its nest, I heard the merchants' cries as they tried to make the birds drop their meat. One of the men came to the nest where I was. And great was his surprise at the sight of me. In fact, he was angry because he thought that I was stealing his diamonds. But I said to him, I am a friend, not a foe. I am carrying with me enough diamonds for both of us. As I was speaking, the other merchants came to the nest, also surprised to find a man in it. They marveled at my story and my bravery in risking the dangers of the flight. Very soon they took me to their camp, and I showed them the size and beauty of my diamonds. They were fair and honest among themselves, and each man only kept the jewels that had come to his particular nest. The merchant who owned the nest to which the eagle had carried me would only take one jewel from me, though I offered him more. I am quite satisfied, he said. Your gift is valuable enough to make a fortune in itself. After spending the night with the merchants, I went with them on the long journey back to their home. At last, I found the way to my own. When I was back again in Baghdad, I gave large sums to the poor. Then, I lived in luxury in my peaceful house, thanks to the riches of my adventures.